Here we go. Okay, I brought this resolution before this board, gosh, it was over a year and a half ago. And we said once a resolution fails, we don't bring it up for another 6 months. Well, it's been over a year and a half. And also, we have a new governor, a new General Assembly, new Senate, new House. And what this resolution concerns for the public, I know the board's had a chance to read this, but it's a question of photo voter ID for fair elections. Some people believe in America our election, our elective process is not as fair as it could be. There's been many, many reports, especially in the Wake County area, across the state, where people are voting, either are voting that are dead or voting out of having no knowledge of what's going on whatsoever. Civitas and John Locke Society, a foundation rather, have done a remarkably good job exposing some of this. Some of it has been people going and registering folks in insane asylums and getting them to vote. And you know that they're telling them who to vote for. And these people are not capable and competent to vote. It is their right to vote. But we have a lot of that going on right now. People are concerned about disenfranchisement, of asking somebody to show their photo ID when they go to vote, when we have to show our photo ID when we go to a political convention. Democrats and Republicans both require it when you go onto the floor. You have to show your photo ID when you go anywhere. We're going to have to show it when we go meet with the governor tomorrow. If this is disenfranchisement, it is just as an egregious, maybe more of a disenfranchisement, to know that your vote is not counting because someone else out there is co-opting dead people to vote and co-opting people who are not of sound mind to vote. So, what I'm asking for in this resolution is that we support the General Assembly because they will take this up in the next long session. This will happen. I'm sure of it. And in sake of saving my voice, I'd rather not read the resolution. But I'm sure we'll have it on our website.
I can read it for you if you want it read.
Would you read it, Hood?
Yeah, I don't mind reading it.
Thank you.
Resolution to request and support that our representatives to the North Carolina General Assembly and our governor pass legislation for voter photo ID. Whereas the right to vote in the United States and the state of North Carolina is a right guaranteed to all citizens by constitutional provision to provide for the combined or transfer of power in this democratic republic. And whereas that the sanctity and the power of one man's vote as a law-abiding citizen should not ever be canceled by the illicit power of someone voting illegally, and whereas it is now fact that there is a vast community of illegal immigrants whom reside in North Carolina by using fraudulent paperwork and do very much benefit by the wrong-headed policies of some unpatriotic politicians, and whereas both houses of the North Carolina General Assembly attempted to make law in Senate Bill 352 and House Bill 351 in the long session of 2011, which stipulates that all prospective voters in all North Carolina elections first provide a photo identification card to verify their identity, and whereas those aforementioned bills passed to effect said efficiencies in voting legal citizens do hereby provide for a variety of identification cards, providing they have a photo and are real, and whereas Governor Beverly Perdue during her administration vetoed both bills in the long session of 2011, originating in the North Carolina General Assembly, and whereas this resolution of support for fair elections in North Carolina was presented to the Beaufort County Board of County Commissioners on July the 5th, 2011 for passage but failed a 5-2 vote at that time. However, now there has been a new election for this Board of County Commissioners, there is a new General Assembly in North Carolina, and there is a new North Carolina governor, and it is most proper to now offer this county support to the efforts of those who wish to wring the vestiges of election fraud in North Carolina. Let it be resolved that the Beaufort County Board of Commissioners do hereby resolve that they offer their support to the North Carolina House of Representatives and the North Carolina State Senate to pass voter photo ID so that elections in North Carolina shall be honest, legal, and fair, so that we may preserve the republic and continue it for future generations of freedom-loving Americans. Written by Stan Deathridge.
Thank you, Hood. You did quite well.
Thank you.
Now submit that to the board, and that is my motion.
All right, we have a motion. Is there a second?
A second.
Okay, discussion, and I'll go first. Of course, you know I'm not going to vote for it, so I'm going to just say that anyway. So, the places you say the voter fraud are, you named specifically Wake County. You didn't name any in Beaufort County.
You got to understand that there's no, you cannot have specific knowledge of voter fraud unless you do, do an investigation. If there's no call for an investigation, you don't investigate. However, we do know that it goes on. It happens. In the election for president, there were some places up north where 19,400 people voted for candidate Obama, and none voted for Romney. Now, that could have happened just like that, but I feel that there may have been some co-opting there. It is being proven throughout the state that this is going on. What I'm saying is everyone should have to show their photo ID. It should be easy for them to get. The state can do it. It is a right to vote, but it is a privilege to do it properly. And only American citizens should have that right to vote. And we can at least try to guard against that in some minor way. And a photo ID is the way to do it.
Okay, I'm going to do one more, then we'll be finished. Well, and I really wouldn't have a problem with the photo ID idea if the state would ensure that everybody who wants one could get one, F-R-E-E.
Yes, I agree. If you want to amend this to put that in there, we could make that as a whereas.
Okay, Commissioner Booth.
Well, I understand that this is going to be a hot item probably in January or February, General Assembly. Yes, we got a new governor. Yes, we got a new Senate. Yes, we got a new House. Yes, we got a new Board of Commissioners. But I hope these commissioners see tonight that we don't have this problem in Beaufort County. I'm going to say it as I said before. I work at DMV. As recently as today, there was a lady came in to get ID and could not get one. If a young lady get married today, she cannot get an ID today. And those are the kind of problems that you have. I mean, and another thing about it is I work for DMV. DMV is not one of the sharpest knives in the draw.
Historically speaking.
It ain't going to change. You just got a new governor. It ain't going to change. But what I'm saying is you got elderly people. In 1984, when I first went there, you could carry your Bible. Elderly people carried Bibles. It was one of the elements that you could use to get an ID card. Yes, now if you're 70 years old, it's free. But they're not giving away that many because the people cannot qualify. You got people here that has never had a birth certificate. You got people when they was recording the birth certificates, midwives, they spelt the name wrong. They would never get an ID card where I work because they don't have the two items that they require you to have. And getting back to the Latino community, none of them come out there with fraudulent identifications. They know now, they're tagged. When they come in our office, the first thing we gotta see is their residence card. If they don't have that, they cannot, they don't even sit in the chair. You gotta have these things. And what you're trying to do here is you got good intent, but it's bad. It's bad business. You're hurting your own residents here in Beaufort County. You got elderly people. Even a lady get married. She cannot go in my office tomorrow and get anything until she go through the Social Security, change her name, and that's a 24-hour process. The election was she got married Saturday, she cannot vote Tuesday. So I hope you would consider this, what you're asking.
Well, I am, and I think if you can't, if you don't have enough foresight to get your ID within 48 hours of an election, then maybe you wouldn't know which candidate to vote for anyway.
Well, Stan, that's probably what you would do, but a woman get married on Sunday, she ain't gonna figure out what get married on Sunday so she can vote Tuesday.
I don't see how getting married has anything to do.
I mean, if you find somebody would marry, you might would do it.
I don't see that getting married has anything to do with voting anyway.
It does, because you don't have the proper ID. You are not who you are. You're not Mrs. Deftridge. If you don't have ID, if you are Mrs. Jones and you married Mr. Deftridge, you're not Mrs. Deftridge on Tuesday. So you cannot vote on Tuesday if you got married on Sunday.
But we are talking about rare instances.
You're not talking about
rare. Then there's always going to be those rare instances that raise their head. When actually it is so important that we safeguard elections in this country, in this state, in this county.
Well, why don't we say?
We don't know that there's not voter fraud in Beaufort County. We just don't know that there's enough to investigate.
I think this way we can pretty much stamp it out.
We do know there's voter fraud because what was it, about 5 or 6 years ago, we had a dead man to vote. And the guy got caught and did it. So, yeah, there's voter fraud everywhere. We had a guy got on the internet and put out this year that he had voted illegally in Beaufort County, he'd voted illegally in Carteret County, he'd voted illegally somewhere else, and then he was going to vote legally on Election Day.
And people like
it was in Carteret County.
And people like him, you're not going to stop. You wouldn't have bank robbers.
Anybody else have anything?
I think that this, you have to look at the gains and losses. With photo ID, you're going to lose, disenfranchise a lot of voters who should be allowed to vote, because they will never ever get that photo ID, and they should have had the right to vote. On the other hand, that may be good for certain political parties to have that happen, because and if you require the voter ID, the transportation for those folks to get, just to go and get the voter ID, is going to discourage some of them from doing it.
I think discourage them to go out and vote.
We
had to go and get people and bring them to the polls because they didn't have rides. We did that. A lot of people come to the polls because they don't have rides.
But they find a way to come and vote. They could find a way to go get a photo ID.
No, they didn't find a way to come and vote. We went and found them.
There's a lot that came and voted. They found a way. Not only did you get win again, but they found a way to come and vote.
I'm not so sure I agree 100% with that. But what you got is a fact that is voter fraud such a problem in this county that you want to disenfranchise a large group of people in order to stamp out voter fraud? I don't think voter fraud is a problem in this county.
Maybe not in Beaufort County, but statewide it probably is.
I don't think there's a voter fraud problem in Carolina.
Mr. Breed, I would challenge you tomorrow, and you've been living in this county ever since Kitty was a pup. If you go out to that office tomorrow and go out there and say, I want an ID card.
Oh, I know I can't get it.
I'm sorry. That's what I'm trying to get you to see. And when you got
They got 4 years right now to get that photo ID.
Not really.
No.
Some of these people, let me tell you something. Some of these people have been working, I'm right here in Beaufort County, some of these people have been trying to get a birth certificate for 5 years and longer. Can't get one. The lost North Carolina law, if I'm not mistaken, Mr. Mill might can help me with this, says you got to find, here's somebody 90 years old, you got to find your oldest sibling. How many of us got oldest siblings that help us get a birth certificate and we never had one? That happens right here in this county every day.
Sure it does.
Every day.
Well, Mr. Chairman.
Go ahead.
I'm sure if this is passed that the political parties are going to call these same people around and get them photo IDs. I'm not worried about that. The whole thing is doable. Using the excuse that you can't get a photo ID is that's just that's laughable.
It's not laughable, it's true.
But, well, I'm sure when this law is passed, there will be some provisions put into place to take care of some of these things. But the truth of the matter, I personally have seen them. Acorn came into Greenville and started scouring the whole town, everybody that they could get, they didn't care who it was, getting people to vote absentee ballots and everything else. There are a lot of voter fraud problems out there. And if people don't think there are, then they're just going to live in Never Never Land because they're the people that are reaping the benefit of those votes. We need to make sure that we don't ever have the problem, for instance, in a county like Beaufort County, by having this legislation passed. The best deterrent to this is to have the law in place, not wait till it gets here, because I'm firmly convinced there is voter fraud out there because we've seen too many instances of it. When you see these people parachuted in here from these various political parties that you've never seen before, and they're scouring and they're doing this, it's been proven they've got nothing to lose by doing a few fraudulent votes and then leaving town. How are you going to find them? How are you going to catch up with them? Voter fraud works.
Commissioner Klein.
Yeah. Stan, I read this thing this afternoon. I read it in detail. And I didn't exactly like the way it flowed and was wondering if you consider some amendments or rewrites to it. Or we consider an alternative resolution, which I went ahead and wrote this afternoon and would be willing to present to you right now.
You look at it.
I'm not looking at it because we've had plenty of time. Mr. Clem's coming in here at the last minute. All he's doing is creating an excuse for him not to vote for this. That's what this is all about. He had plenty of time to get to the commissioners. His alternative for this, bringing it up Johnny on the spot at the last minute, is nothing but a sham. And he's not going to vote for it. I can tell you that right now. It wouldn't matter if we put his up there. He wouldn't vote for it.
I will vote for the resolution that I wrote in relation to.
That's what I just said. You've given the excuse for why you're not going to vote for this. You've already done that. It's a sham.
No, it's no sham. I didn't like the way Stan's was written. In my opinion, it's an unprofessional document. It's not fit to send to the legislature.
That is totally untrue. That is a gross statement by someone who is ignorant of what the legislature gets.
Well, I would like to send them a much better document than that.
I'm sure your writing abilities are superior to mine. However, give me a moment just to read this.
Here we go, trying to get people jobs. They're cutting the food over something.
I read it. I don't know if my voice would last tonight. I feel like crap.
I'll read it for you.
I thought you
wasn't
going to read it.
I wasn't going to read it. I mean, Clem's making so many excuses. I want you to see when this is over with. Clem's not going to vote for any of this stuff. This is a sham. Resolution in support of the state photo ID law. Whereas throughout our nation's history, fair and free elections have been the benchmarks that set the United States of America apart from nations around the world. Recently, citizens from many of these nations have been witnessed demanding more freedom and accountability from their respective governments. Many times elections are arranged to keep dictators in power or to replace one regime with another that is even more brutal. Whereas, given the current political climate throughout our nation, many of our communities are anxious to ensure that one of our most basic and fundamental rights will continue to be protected. That right is further being diminished through illegal registration. Votes by convicted felons who have lost their right to vote, multiple votes by the same individual, and those who reside illegally within the United States requiring identification from those who are charting our communities and nation's future is not unreasonable. And given notice now will provide many months to allow those individuals to secure their required identification. And whereas some have advised this requirement would place an undue hardship on certain individuals in our communities, currently individuals are required by law to have a North Carolina driver's license with a photo for identification purposes. Photo IDs are required when seeking care in a hospital and for travelers at airports. Individuals cannot open bank accounts, nor can they send or receive money transactions without proper identification. And whereas before the introduction of one-stop voting and same-day registration, the deadline to register to vote was 25 days prior to Election Day. This deadline was intended to give the country, the county boards of elections, time to complete the administrative task required to maintain an accurate voter list by mailing out the legally required verification notices, voter cards to ensure that the registrants' addresses were valid. In turn, county boards are required by law to wait 1 month for any cards to be returned undeliverable if the address is not valid. The advent of one-stop voting and same-day registration has rendered the verification process useless, as all elections will have been certified by the time the validation process is completed. Let it be resolved that the Beaufort County Board of Commissioners offer their support to the North Carolina House of Representatives and the North Carolina Senate to pass voter photo ID to ensure that the person voting has shown proper identification prior to casting his ballot. Be it further resolved that copies of this resolution shall be forwarded to Representative Paul Tyne, Representative Mike Speciale, Senator Bill Cook, Governor Pat McCrory, and the North Carolina Association of County Commissioners.
Well, first, let me just say this. Let me take back the comment I said that your writing abilities were far superior to mine. Okay, let me take that back. This reads more like an editorial. Now, if you can find one or two specific things to interject and what I wrote, which is written more like a resolution, I would be more than glad to do it. But I wouldn't want to vote for this.
We all have our own personal opinions.
Yeah.
All right. Any further discussion? All right. All in favor of Commissioner Deathard's resolution, raise your right hand. All opposed? Yeah. Commissioner Klein, which way you voting?
I voted against it.
Okay.
I like to make
that's twice
vote.
You voted for the possibility there be voter fraud.
Mr. Chair,
twice.
I want to make a motion.
Hold on a second.
And I make a motion that this don't be brought back up in 6 months.
Well, I haven't been able to make my motion on.
Yeah, ain't talking about your motion. I'm talking about Staines.
I really don't think that's a good idea in this case, because this is going to be a hot item and it needs to be debated and discussed.
Well, we can't do anything about it. It's going to take the legislators.
Yes, we can.
I make a motion that this don't be brought back up in 6 months.
We have a motion. Is there a second?
Third.
Have a second. Any discussion?
Yeah. First of all, this is just to show our predilection of support for stopping and stemming voter fraud in this state. I understand you got 3 Republicans and 4 Democrats that want to continue what's going on. I think it's wrong. I think we've had in this nation, when we began this nation years ago, our founders made it difficult for people to vote. They established the Electoral College so that the areas in the agrarian states would have a greater propensity for their votes to count more. Now we've got a situation where, as expressed by Commissioner Belcher, that you go and pick people up and they may or not have any ID, and you haul them to the polls and you get them to vote for your candidate, and you just keep moving them around. You go find people to vote. You go find people to vote for your candidate. It's not, we're not at the point now where it is a right that we have to do something as a patriot to do what we think is best. We're grabbing people and saying, I'll take you to the polls if you vote for my candidate. And, oh, by the way, you don't need a photo ID. I think that is just so we've deterred so far from where our forefathers wanted us to be. Of course, Jim Crow stopped the whole idea that you had to own property before you could vote. I mean, Jim Crow took a good idea and made it wrong. Very, very, very wrong.
Stand there trying to
but we're talking, no, we're talking about 2 separate periods of history, when we first began and when things went wrong after the Civil War. And we have gotten so far afield where we're talking about disenfranchising people because they have to prove that they are a reasonable person, a citizen of this nation. I find that, I just find it completely ridiculous.
Okay, anybody else? Okay, we have a motion and a second. All in favor, Commissioner Booth, raise your right hand.
What was the motion?
Not to bring it back up in 6 months.
Okay.
Yours.
Okay.
Okay. All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed. 3-4, so it failed.
Okay.
Okay, Mr. Commissioner Klein.
Yeah, I'd like to make a resolution in support of the alternative resolution that I presented tonight.
You want to make a motion?
Yes.
All right, you have a motion. Is there a second? Hearing none, it dies.
Well, for the purposes of having a vote, I'll second it.
Okay. Have a motion and a second. Any discussion?
Yeah, I'll discuss. I know this is an ego-driven power play, but I'm going to vote for it because I believe in it that much. It's written like an editorial. It's written like a 10th grader, and it's almost pathetic. But I will vote for it because I believe in this so much.
My comment is I would just like for you to put a note on there that says Hood Richardson is embarrassed by the language in this resolution.
I will not accept that amendment.
Come on, I'm voting for it.
I'm going to vote for it, too,
Al. We're going to vote for it,
it's
Al.
An important enough issue that we're going to vote for it.
All right, have a
go on. Show some humility.
And a second. All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed. Mr. Clemens.
Okay.
Passes.
I voted for something that was written with crayons. Hallelujah.
Well, you know the old saying, if you don't stand for something, you'll fall for it.
That's exactly right.
There you go.
We vote in the press.
Second in.
Okay, let's get back on track. Bobby Parker.